Today, everyone is talking about the AI bubble, and many compare it to the dot-com bubble. So in this video, I wanted to show you how and why the dot-com bubble happened, and if it was possible to avoid it. First of all, I want to give you a brief context. 90s in America were a time of advancement and growth in pretty much everything. The economy was booming. Personal computers were becoming a norm. By 97, 35% of households owned a personal computer. With the personal computer, internet becomes more widespread as well. So, suddenly you have the brand new internet industry emerging, and everyone wants to be part of it. The adoption of personal computers and the web triggered a boom for new internet companies. Yahoo for web navigation. Amazon, which famously started as an online bookstore in 94. eBay in 95. They were the early pioneers who proved that their real business could be done online. And things were going amazing. Thanks to the strong economy and low interest rates, you had a lot of money going around. So, venture capital firms rushed into Silicon Valley, incentivizing kind of new startups. So, if you were an internet startup in the 90s, it was extremely easy for you to raise millions, as there were a lot of potential investors with the fear of missing out. And things like profitability, a viable business model, etc., no one cared about them.
There's no revenue. No one wants to see revenue. Go.
So, on top of the genuinely fair business models, there were many kind of questionable ones. For example, pets.com, essentially Amazon that is purely focused on dog food delivery nationwide.
Ooh, hey, poodles! Did you know that pets.com delivers food, treats, and toys?
Cosmo.com, also e-commerce promising free delivery of anything under 1 hour. Which actually sounds cool, but can you really make it a profitable business model?
I think I'll go get a video and some chocolate ice cream.
You're gonna go out for that?
Cosmo.com has videos and ice cream.
Kozmo.com.
Then investment banks also joined the bandwagon. They realized they can instantly profit from the tech startups doing an IPO and becoming public. The IPO boom started from Netscape, the company behind the popular web browser of that time. They had an IPO in 95 and their market value more than doubled on day one. This IPO is considered the birth of the dot-com bubble. And from that point, IPOs exploded. Yahoo in 96, Amazon in 97, eBay in 98, and many others. By the year 98, the dot-com mania reaches full speed. The pattern is always the same. An internet startup get early VC funding easily. It burns a lot of money, don't care about profitability.
What? So, revenue? No revenue. I'll call you back.
It focuses on website traffic and media attention. Then they launch an IPO and like everyone becomes crazy rich on paper. By the year 2000, the dot-com craze is at its peak. NASDAQ soared from 1,000 to over 5,000 points in just a few years. Media headlines were claiming that like stores, malls, newspapers, basically everything, would soon be replaced by the internet. And you had startups with zero revenue buying 2 million Super Bowl ads. The first problems began in early 2000s when the Fed increased interest rates. Suddenly, investors started counting money and realized that most of these companies weren't making any profits.
But if you have no revenue, you can say you're pre-revenue.
Then a few public companies reported bad earnings. So startups that depended on endless funding suddenly could not raise more and were running out of cash. With all of it, NASDAQ started dropping, and at some point it converted to like mass panic. So everyone started selling the tech stocks. In the late 2000s, the wave of bankruptcies kicked in. Pets.com, the dog food delivery company, bankrupt 9 months after the IPO. Cosmo.com, Webvan raised $1 billion, lost everything, eToys, and many others. NASDAQ fell 80% in less than 2 years. In total, over half of all dot-com startups failed. Technically speaking, it's not too bad. Amazon lost 90% of its stock value, same for other tech companies like Cisco or Yahoo. Layoffs, unfortunately, hit tens of thousands of employees. The bubble bursting and a lot of people affected is definitely bad news. But as you can see, the internet itself did not die. It continued growing. So basically, the companies with a sustainable business model and long-term vision survived. And some became tech giants we know today. Amazon, some predicted it would go bankrupt, but it did not. eBay, Google, PayPal, others, these companies came to dominate their respective fields. On top of this, the new generation of tech companies emerged after the bubble. Facebook, YouTube, and others. All these companies shaped the internet that we know and use today. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed, click like and subscribe, as more stories are coming soon. See ya.